So President Trump is speaking at CPAC this afternoon amid a debate in your party about its future. So I'm sure you've heard Congressman Liz Cheney say President Trump should not have a role in the Republican Party moving forward. What do you think?
You got, I have a lot in that question. Let me put it this way. We've got to win in 2 years. We've got to win in 4 years. If we do that, we'll do that by speaking to those issues that are important to the American people. And there's a lot of issues important to them right now, not by putting one person on a pedestal and making that one person our focal point. If we do that, if we speak to those issues, to those families, to those individuals, we win. That's where our focus should be.
Well, it doesn't sound like the former president's influence is diminishing. You talked about putting him on a pedestal. He was literally, his face was in bronze at this CPAC event that's going on. Top Republicans are flying down to Mar-a-Lago to meet with him. My understanding is that the essence of his speech will be that he's not going anywhere. So can the GOP move forward in the direction you were just talking about with Trump still very much in the spotlight?
First, CPAC is not the entirety of the Republican Party. That's number one. Number two, political organizations and campaigns are about winning. Over the last 4 years, we lost the House of Representatives, the Senate, and the presidency. That has not happened in a single 4 years under a president since Herbert Hoover. Now, if we plan to win in 2022 and 2024, we have to listen to the voters. Not just those who really like President Trump, but also those who perhaps are less sure. If we speak to the voters who are less sure, who went from President Trump to President Biden, we win. If we don't, we lose. That is a reality that we have to confront.
Can you just clarify that? Are you saying that the party should try to sideline or ignore the former president in order to achieve what you just described? Is he at fault for losing? Obviously, he's at fault for losing the White House, but Congress too?
If you're going to win in 2022 and 2024, you got to speak to voters who didn't vote for us last time. Now, our policies were great. Before the COVID crisis hit, we had record employment for every group. Hispanics, African Americans, women, the disabled, high school dropouts, veterans, you name it. We had economic policies that were working. So if that's the case, and we can speak to those policies, to those families, then we'll win. But if we idolize one person, we will lose. And that's kind of clear from the last election.
Okay, I want to get to COVID relief. One more question on this. Your leader, Senator Mitch McConnell, said this week that he would support former President Trump if he wins the nomination in 2024. You are one of those who voted to convict him, but looking ahead, do you think Donald Trump is fit to be president again?
I don't think Donald Trump, he'll be 78 years old, but I don't think he'll be our nominee for the reasons I've said. Over the last 4 years, we've lost the House, the Senate, and the presidency. Political campaigns are about winning. Our agenda does not move forward unless we win. We need a candidate who can not only win himself or herself, but we also have to have someone who lifts all boats. And that's clearly not happened over the last 4 years.
Is he fit to be president?
That's a theoretical that I don't think will come to pass. I'm sorry?
Is he fit to be president again?
You're asking me a question for 4 years from now, which, again, okay. I don't mean to duck, but you could ask me a lot of people if they're fit. Point is, I don't think he's going to be our nominee for the reasons I just described.